to talk to, it was a review that looked at all these different approaches, not psychedelic included. It was skills training, job interviews, employment, music, all this other stuff. And employment programs and social skills training were found to be the most effective. And they also found that most approaches that they did in this like meta-analysis were looking at like mitigating deficits rather than providing support or resource or like guidance, like life skills training. So this emphasis on like, we must normalize you and then you'll be better, versus like, we need to find a way for your abnormalcy to thrive, is kind of a recurrent theme that we're trying to, while we have this interesting window with psychedelics, it's an interesting time to also reframe the kind of care. So it's kind of like an abrupt kind of slide into home plate at 2 minutes prior to this stop time here. But I did want to take what time we have here just to reflect to you guys and to invite you to also hang out like on the patio space for a little bit if you'd like. But despite the fact that I have talked in depth a lot about a lot of things, I just wanted to restate gratitude for all of you guys. I know that I also connect a lot of like logistics in. This is like our first go live. But do know that the assurances that I have provided to you are yours to take. And then that includes having access to the textbook when it is in stock here this week at our table. So find us there at the latest. I would say Thursday is the day that it's supposed to. I've been like on the phone yelling about the publisher. But, so pick that up. If not, I'll mail it to you. I'll make any of these assurances follow through. You guys all have my email and contact. If you go to autisticpsychedelic.com, just email me. If any of these lapse, just find me. But you guys are all guaranteed that textbook. You're all guaranteed to also get access to the online course we're doing the first 4 Saturdays in August, 10 a.m. to 12 p.m. Pacific, also recorded. And you'll be with even more people that are joining us from all around the world in that same class to look at some of these materials. And I'll also try to create a kind of transparent schedule should you decide you wanted to show up for like discussion portions. You're welcome to just do that too, to kind of be like, you mostly saw this and you can mostly read this. So I think the biggest value add is in like the cross-dialoguing and like networking for some of you guys as well. But those are all guaranteed to you, and I just re-express my gratitude to all of you for being here. It means a tremendous amount to be able to do this, and I will and have talked for a long time already, and I would keep talking. And if not for the patio space, if you guys are at the conference as well, we have booth 338. We'll be out there all 3 days upcoming. And I'll also be talking at noon tomorrow, somehow. I'll be talking at noon tomorrow on the stage in room 201, if you guys can make it. It'd be cool to have some folks in there. It's just a half-hour panel on affirming care, some of the stuff we talked about today. I'll be talking about that tomorrow. But short of that, I'm going to try to be semi-perfect about it, say it's 10 o'clock. And yeah, you guys are more or less released for now. And yeah. Like I said, you guys are welcome to chill up front for the sake of courtesy to the space holders, if we can kind of clear out.